Alrighty, back to Yoshi's Island, and first things first, let's take that stupid little frame rate display off of there. Show frame rate. While I'm here, look at all the wild options we got for output image filtering. We've got all of the awful, lame, like, squishy stuff, like, bleh. But, there's some interesting NTSC filters on here. I'm not going to use them for the stream, but, this is more like the TV I would have been playing on, you know, at NTSC composite. Kind of bad, but kind of expect at the same time. This is the RGB, which is pretty... about the best image you can get out of a CRT, I believe. I'm not sure exactly how accurate these are. I haven't actually used a CRT in ages. But I thought these are a cute little addition. I think this... you can even get shaders and, like, do all sorts of different stuff, but we're just going to be playing with naked pixels. Hey, Sun Gaming. Also, let me double check that Hey, Pepsi Man. Alright, yeah, it looks fine. So, I cut off a teeny bit of the bottom of the map because a little bit of the screen isn't used in level, and I'm not sure exactly what that's about. It's probably some technical thing. Because this is, you know, a pretty technically accomplished game. No, that's a filter. You must have been seeing a filter anyway. Higgin does have, it does have a TV filter. It's a little less aggressive. I'm not sure if it's more or less accurate, but it's less strong than the, some of the ones this comes with. But, and yeah, we're doing SNES 9X. I'm not entirely sure how to set up SNES 9X, so it's mostly default. But, I just turned the audio buffer to minimal. And, things seem... pretty accurate. I'm sure it's not exactly as accurate as Higgin, but, we won't have the audio crackles and stuff. Hey, Shade Kirby. So, that's more important to me than... than 100. Like, I would rather have 99% accuracy and no audio skips than 100% accuracy, but then, you know, the audio screws up because it doesn't, you know, render enough frames, so. I don't know why Higgin... I could have sworn my PC was good enough to run Higgin. I mean, if my PC isn't processor-wise, I mean, there's very few things that are. So I don't know what the deal is with that exactly, but, oh well. Pepsi Man Senpai is in chat. Boink. The flutter jump is so good. I'm surprised I never used it in any... well, they used it in later Yoshi games, but, it just has so much personality. Oh, and yeah, the, there was no trouble at all moving over the, save file from Higgin. You just had to rename it and put it in the right place, and then boom, my, save file loaded right up. Excuse me. I don't know why I'm even bothering this. I think this is, like, either the slot machine or the scratch card thing. Both of those sucks. I think it takes until World 3 or 4 until we get the, really good goal game. The, match 2. Drawing lots. Oh! We haven't seen this one, actually. God damn it. I hate these. The early ones are all luck, and they all have that Kamek card that, like, screws you over entirely. Yeah, I used to really like ZSNES, and just... it has a bit of nostalgia. It feels weird to have nostalgia for an emulator, but it's what I used to use. And, also, if you didn't know, you could scroll the little map with L and R. It's cute to get, does it work? I think it does. Yeah, you can get a little preview. I was always so excited to, you know, oh, what am I gonna be seeing? What am I gonna be seeing? You know, you could scroll over and see some stuff. Top row is evil. Not sure you... oh, you mean the, yeah, the card slot game. I was gonna say. Oh yeah, but ZSNES. Yeah, I used it a lot, but it does just enough annoying stuff. It's a very DOS-y sort of emulator. You know, it steals your input focus. It's really weird. It acts like it's its own operating system. That's why I call it DOS-y. It just doesn't play nice. It also has some sound issues that SNES 9X didn't have for me. Except for ROM hacks. It doesn't like the ROM hacks? Huh. I would have figured ROM hacks would work as well as anything else. But let's get started then. Welcome to Monkey Worlds. Oh, I love every background, and I've said this every time, but... Also, they make some really good use of palette swapping of this and some other backgrounds. Aw, come on. How's the image on... Aw, damn it, it's dropping frames again. Aw, come on. I'm... trapping. Yeah, my ISP just sucks. And they claimed their repair guy said he came and, like, serviced the house. But we know that's not true because he never called and the door wasn't unlocked. Like, they said they would call and they didn't. So I'm not happy with Mediacom. Yeah, I don't... not this again. Yeah, I'm streaming at about the lowest that I can without causing, like, major issues. So, if this doesn't work... Parker, please! I don't know if this is gonna happen tonight, if it's gonna be this bad. Is it as awful as it sounds on your... as looks like... I'm seeing 20% drop frames. Is it, like, unwatchable over at your end? I really don't want to do a stream and just have to be talking about drop frames the entire time. I always really love the muddy levels. See if I have anything going on my end, but I seriously, seriously doubt there is anything. Yeah, there's really nothing. Source monitor. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's just freaking... Parker, please, get down. Get down. I really wish we had better freaking internet in this company, in this country. It's pretty freaking ridiculous. Parky is briefly stable. I don't really know of anything else I can do. What do you want, Parker? Calm down. Oh, this is a cute little secret. Oh, I ruined it. I just love how realistic the mud stuff felt. They did a really great job making the world feel alive in this game. I think Comcast and Time Warner are about the worst in terms of business practices, anyway. Oh right, this is a fun one. I also love these giant donut lifts. Ah, frick. I'm panicking. Give me that. Don't you laugh at me! Laughed at me. How freaking rude. Also love the little clouds in the background. Love pretty much everything in the background. The background's really great. Oh, and these little things that tip! Give me that. Oh, wait, I think that's a red one.
Yep.
Hey, James. On the little... It's Muddy Mud Skipper! I guess they're frogs, but I'm gonna call them Muddy Mud Skipper. Immediate comm has experienced problems? Huh. I didn't think Down Detector would have... would know, if local ISPs are having issues. That's pretty cool. I mean, it's not cool that they're having issues, but it's cool that they detect that. Hi, Mario Gamer. Glad you enjoyed the Slime Rancher stream. Yeah, I don't know. I was having issues yesterday, and they keep telling me they're not having troubles. Let me just at them, just to keep up the pressure, I guess. Is how bad is the stream? Issues since 9 a.m. EST? What was that, Parker? Parker? Hold on.
What'd you do?
Don't know what that sound was. Hold on. Okay. Sorry about that. Yeah, when it drops, it's like... It's not like having not enough. It just drops to zero upload. And I think it did that while I was saying that, so I don't even know if you heard that. Okay, you know what? I'm gonna do two levels, and if people say it's bad enough after two levels, I'm just gonna stop for tonight. I don't know. I might have to actually. If you said they're having trouble since 9 a.m. I don't know. I thought maybe streaming earlier would fix it, but it didn't really do that last time. Like, it's I still had issues yesterday. Not this bad, but. It's pretty much all around their coverage map. Whoa. I'm not sure if that area just naturally has slowed down, because that... A few SNES games do slow down. Super Mario World has crazy slow down, especially in ROM hacks. It's hidden mostly in the main game just because they don't put enough things. You have one sprite too many on Super Mario World, and it just flips out. Which is why it's funny that people brag about, oh, retro games did 99 or 60 FPS all the time. It's like, well, yeah, when there wasn't lag on screen. SNES is mostly free of lag, but NES, not so much. And I can't believe I missed one freaking red coin. Yeah, there's a lot of evidence that Mario World was pretty rushed. Also, I love that popping the March and Mild is, they bounce the other enemies around. Hey, you gamer. Ow. More than usual? Well, I mean, no, this is unfortunately pretty much the new usual, which is the problem. Like, there's kind of not been any safe time. Ah, dang it. Wait, can I just exit? I guess I can't. Oh well. Oh wait, maybe I can get it back. When he's not guiding you around Poochie is pretty cool. Alright, that was a weird little secret. Pops you up over here. Let's see if I can... Aw, oh, no. He'll be fine. He's made of tough stuff. Yeah, Mediacom does not get very good reviews. So I guess that red coin really is gone. They're the only option here, though. I can't get anything else. Unless I want to get, you know, dial-up. Alright, let's... What? There you go. There we go. Uh-oh! There we go. Let's get those red coins. Oops. There we are. No, there's no AT&T here. I mean, cell phone, yes, but no, not wired. Unless things have changed in the last year or so, but I kind of doubt it. It sucks because the actual, like, the maximum bandwidth I get is perfectly fine and is better than most places get, really. But if I can't sustain, like, 1 megabit, that's pretty freaking dire. Oop. Thank you. I see that red coin. Hey, buddy. I'm just gonna slip by you. There we go. Watch us only lose by that one red coin. Oh. I actually feel better about that, because it wasn't just that one red coin. I'm not sure what I missed, though. I don't know. How is the stream looking? Are we kind of okay, or...? I've pretty much done everything I can do at this point. Oh, and Nep-inut is, it's Neptune with the second syllable backwards. So, it's like God of the Sea. Oh, and I freaking love these trees. Alright, fun thing I forgot to show off. No, stop giving me eggs. Boop! Spits them all out at once. Oh, and I love the- look at the high-tech, bushy eyebrow technology on those dudes. Those guys' sprites are actually really impressive. I'm pretty sure their teeth are two separate sprites. So is their face, as well as their body. I think there's at least 4 separate sprites total. Tap-Tap the Red Nose is also 4 or 5 sprites together. Gimme. Yeah, I'll definitely upload the local copy for pretty much any time this stream issues. I do that. It froze when I was showing off the ground pound, oh, for Pete's sake. I could swear there's something up there, isn't there? Oh, whatever. Yeah, I really prefer the blargs in Mario in Yoshi's Island to the ones in World. Also, I like all the little secrets hidden in this room. Or, monkeys. Monkeys, come here. Yoshi needs you. Aw, frick. Ah, dang it. And there goes all of the stars. But Yoshi, or Mario. Whatever. Where did all of my eggs go? I don't even remember using them all. Is there somewhere I can get freaking eggs here? Oh, here we go. Yes, feed me eggs. Come here. Come here. Nope. Alright, come here, Neptune. Or Nep-a-Newt. Come on. Get over here. My whole plan was to lure him all the way to the right so I could get past him. Oh, I forgot those guys steal Mario. There we go. Oh, for Pete's sake. I guess it doesn't matter. As long as you have 10 stars, getting hit doesn't really matter. Oh, I already got all the red coins. I'm stupid. Oh, there we go. Oh, I missed one. Whatever. This one? Oh, just more stars. Ah! Star, get back down here. Thank you. This is Fort Yoshi. No girl Yoshi's allowed. You always gotta pound in all of the things. Partially because of secrets and also because it's just very satisfying. Hyperdimension Nep-a-Newt. Gimme. Yes! It feels extremely satisfying to get back to 30 stars from like a not guaranteed source of stars. Oh, and it's these little dudes! These guys are one of my favorite things in the game. They're completely pointless and yet so freaking awesome. Huffin' Puffins, I believe they're called. Yeah, you throw their young as eggs, and then they come back to you, and they go on this cool arc. They are completely unnecessary and dumb, and also completely amazing and awesome. The males make eggs, but that doesn't make them mean they can reproduce. Oh right, these guys! These are another weird enemy. I don't know if these guys show up in any other levels either. There's a lot of enemies like that, that are only in a couple levels. It gives this game a great sense of personality. And yeah, it is there is a rather famous Twitter person with the Huffin' Puffin as their icon. I think they managed to get an animated one too. I completely forget where I need to go with this. In here, I think? Yeah. Oh, look at that mud erasing the door. I didn't know that happened. I guess it's just because there's so many sprites it overlaps. Animated Twitter icons. Oh, they removed that feature. Oh, and this is an area I really love the look of this area. I've said that about every area, but I still always mean it. But nah, Twitter used to let you upload GIFs as your avatar. The only trick is that you have to have done that back when that was possible and never change your avatar. Sub Yoshi is probably my favorite of the transformations. Also, look at the little Goomba squids! As a kid, I never really put the connection, but I'm pretty sure those are supposed to be Goomba squids. Yeah, I think the music's having a little bit of issues here, but it's still less bad than Higgins' music issue. Yeah, there's definitely seem to be Goombas, little things. Also, these things take 3 hits. Excuse you. Please take the 3rd hit. There you go. It's not this game, it's just my stupid internet service provider. Uh-oh, those are- oh! I am confused, because everything looks like a red coin down here. Okay, slow down. Also, the red coins are pink underwater. I think- I'm not sure if this area lags on SNES or not. It's been a long time since I played. Look at all the rocks. Look at the... Ugh, look at everything. It's all great. No, it's nothing to do with my end. It's all Mediacom. It doesn't matter what I do. I've confirmed this many, many ways. I hate this frog bastard. Look at his smug face. Look at him. I hate him. I don't think you can even do anything to the frog. He just ducks. He's a freaking jerk. What we can do, though... Look, over here, Froggy. Come here, Froggy. I think he despawned. Oh, there he is! Ha! Take that. Also, those fish are one of fairly few enemies that don't give an egg. One of fairly few swallowable enemies, anyway. Oh, and there's little frogs in the water here. I love the little frogs. It's not this game, guys. It does it to absolutely everything. And these are the little dudes that- Oh! Huffin' Puffin's one-hit KO those! I didn't know that. Oh, and Huffin' Puffin's die if you hit them into those. I didn't know that either. Yeah, Huffin' Puffin's are usually reusable. Screw off, buddy. Yeah, the frog's a real jerk. But you can usually get around them pretty easy. Hey, Sorten. Also, I think I missed some stuff when I got the helicopter. I thought that was an optional side area. And it, in fact, was not. Oops! Alright, and those die. The Huffin' Puffins fall down if they, ricochet too many times. Also, I love these sideways hopping guys. Isn't there a secret over here? No, I guess not. I love his little walking animation, his stair walk animation. Up! Oh! Rest in peace, Huffin' Puffin. You were the best. Oh, frick! Oh well. I'm pretty sure there's something down here. Oh, you freaking! I call wall hacks! That was wall hacks! That was wall hacks. You saw it. It would probably just have its own- they probably wouldn't have localized something weird like... I mean, they probably wouldn't have- oh, you can just swallow the frogs? I didn't know that. I guess you just can't egg them. But yeah, Tetra's attack wouldn't happen now because it was like a weirdly localized, you know, censor the Japanese out of it sort of game, which even Nintendo doesn't really do these days. Wait. Can you kill the frogs? Or was I just having trouble? I know the frogs are tricky, but I forget if... I guess they're less invincible than I was thinking. Alright, this guy. Wait, what was the trick to that guy? I thought you had to do something and get like a one-up off of him. Maybe I have to hit him with an egg. Hold up, I'm gonna refill my drink here. Shows a Japanese influence on the predominantly female cast. I guess they could. That could be it. 90s Nintendo. Well, 90s gaming in general, but also Nintendo was pretty awful in a lot of ways. You know, there were good games, but business-wise, pretty much everything was awful and evil, which nobody really likes to talk about. It's not exactly... It doesn't really mesh with the nostalgia, because, you know, we were all dumb kids. We didn't know about all the nasty bits. Excuse me. Oops. No! Yeah, intentionally didn't leave you at the results screen. A friend of mine did not know, like, who does not play many games. He didn't know that you could, like, skip, like, we were playing Scott Pilgrim, and it was on one of those screens that counts down your score really slowly and plays an annoying sound effect. And I left to go do something, and he didn't, like, you know, he wasn't really a gamer, so he didn't really know that he could skip it. So it was still counting down when I came back, like, a couple of minutes later, and I was like, oh. Oops. Yoshi does this weird thing where he sort of panics for the first few frames after you gain control of him, so he kind of falls into stuff. I see you, monkey. Come here. Oh, yeah, everybody was pretty nasty back then. Mostly Nintendo and Sega, but mostly because, you know, they were the platform holders. Atari was pretty gross too, but they were not relevant anymore by this time. This is a pretty good fortress, by the way. It's not really many bad fortresses. Bleh. But, Ah, frick. This is a pretty good room, if you're good with ricochets, to get some star things. I'm not really gonna bother, though. I'll bother with 100% later. Because that'll be a lot easier once I have my Yoshi legs back. This, the SNES and this game was... Ooh! So that meant to do that. All skill. This game and Donkey Kong Country 1 were my first games. I think I mentioned that first stream. But then I got a Genesis later, and I found Genesis games a lot harder, because a lot of Genesis games did the, like, they didn't have save files. And was there a reason for that? Like, I know some, like, Sonic 3 has a save file. But, like, I had Vector Man, I had the Sonic games, I had the Genesis Aladdin. What else did I have? I didn't have as many Genesis games as SNES, but I did get it later. And honestly, I didn't know too many games other than my friends and Nintendo Power. I never really got any magazines that had Sega stuff, so aside from Sonic... Ah, damn it. Yeah, aside from Sonic, I didn't really know much Sega stuff. Which is unfortunately why my Dreamcast was kind of the Sonic machine. I didn't really get too many of the really cool games that it had at the time. I simply did not know they existed. But you know, as little teen Tap Tap, was I a teen? Was I a hot teen? I forget. Oh, no, I would have been on... Dreamcast was what, 2000? I guess it would have been 10, that's not exactly. But, never had a Genesis. It was a pretty cool console, but I didn't have too many games that I really liked on it. I didn't like it as much as the Super Nintendo, but I think it's mostly just because of the games that I happened to get. Though, I mean, SNES did have the better library in general, but get into the thing! I fear that would have killed him. But it's funny, the monkeys have two states. After they get hit on the head, they turn a less vibrant shade of brown, and they stop being hostile. Kind of a neat little touch. There's such a good variety of enemies in this game, and enemy behaviors. But yeah, it definitely, I did not like the arcade mindset. I still don't like the arcade mindset. I also never knew Sonic 2 had a level select. My sister knew, and she never told me. And like, I was like just failing at this game constantly, and she's just like, I held a little bit of a grudge for that for a while. Because I never knew that. All the while, I thought she was way better at Sonic, but she just had the cheat codes. Also, it feels kind of weird, but like, you know, I never looked online for like cheat codes and stuff until PlayStation 2, I think, because I remember doing it for GTA. There was this website called Game Winners, and it looks so incredibly 90s. I wonder if it's still around, but they had cheat codes and stuff. It was like, it's not quite GameFAQs, it's mostly for cheat codes, but it had stuff for that. Did you play the first Mario, Zelda, and Metroid? Not as a kid I didn't, because I didn't have an NES. My first Metroid game was actually Metroid Prime 2. And then I went backwards from that. Well, then I got Prime as well, but I played pretty much all of the Metroid games last gen. Game Winners is still up here. I found those way before. I think they were up before GameFAQs. I started using those after the totally useless, or pretty close to it, guide for FNES, Final Fantasy IX. That guide is awful. If you never had it, they had this play online thing. They would literally have like, oh, there's a side quest in blah blah blah. Maybe if you go to play online, you can find out how to do it. And the guide, the paper guide that you spent like 20 of your little kid dollars on, which is like a fortune, did not have that information at all. It just told you to go to this website. I hated that guide. I stopped buying strategy guides after that, pretty shortly after that. I still got some PlayStation 2 ones, but that was one of the last guides I ever got. Oh, nope, 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 nope. I gotta get... No! Oh, no, frick. Oh, well. I probably wasn't gonna get 100% anyway. I think what you have to do for that one... no. Yeah, you... Alright, I think maybe you have to flutter in the air? I don't know. It's been a while. Crash Team Racing? I never had Crash Team... I never had any Crash stuff as a kid, actually. Oh, speaking of guides, there was like... some like premium guides thing they had for that they released for Final Fantasy 7 through 9 or 10, was it? Did they fix all of the stuff that was missing from the 9 guide? I also heard those were kind of ugly, which like the whole point of, you know, a fancy premium guide released 10 years later is, you know, about the looks and quality. Look at this smug bastard. Look at this piece of crap. Look. Look at this. Hold on. Oh, I didn't drag it onto OBS. This bastard. Alright. Great job, Yoshi! Now you'll be Froggy's lunch! Hee-hee-hee! Oh, input wasn't enabled. Look at Yoshi's face! Oh, this was a really cool, fight, too. Huh? Ah, hold on. I need to change something. It's not taking input while it's... pause when inactive. The game still plays... oh, here we go. Enable background input. Alright, that's better. I wonder how many DeviantArt fetishes were born from this. Also, the egg's act really weird in the stomach. Yeah, I didn't really enjoy Zelda 1 very much at all. I played it after basically every other Zelda, and I did use a guide through pretty much all of it. It just was bleh. Like, it's easy to see why it was revolutionary, but it's just... Like, unless you have the patience to really go in blind, it's just kind of a weird... Where are the Shy Guys coming from? He's eating them, I guess. Look at poor Yoshi. He's traumatized. Ultrona, you're gonna wanna not talk about the frames constantly. Zelda 2 is a really interesting game, just not, it's very hard. Well, obviously there's like a Shy Guy Rube Goldberg machine just off screen that, you know, the frog is eating from. Very reasonable. Also take this gen, you know, 7th gen destructible terrain. Yoshi's Island had it. And gen 6 or 7? PS3 gen, never really, aside from, what's it called? Red Faction Guerrilla, it, didn't really deliver on the whole destructible terrain thing. No, come here, Yoshi. Oh, right, the little potted cacti that come after you. You can grab the pot, too. Bloop. Yeah, I really liked what Zelda 2 had going on for it, but I never did finish that one. I finished Zelda 1 with a... with a guide. Frick, what? Okay. Nope. Get out of here. All right. Yeah, no, I don't think any Pokemon gen is gonna have much destructible terrain. Though, considering the Pokédex entry for Tyranitar, it probably should, but, just casually obliterate the entire map. Just Pokémon things. Didn't get too far into Mario 2 either. I had that for the... I had the Game Boy Advance remake. It's pretty fun, but... I don't know. It didn't cling to me like SMB3 or Yoshi's Island. Is there secrets here? Ugh, you jerk. I want to see if there's maybe something in the corner. Eh, maybe not. Huh? Excuse me? There we go! That was awkward. Oh yeah, the Birdo! I forget about the Birdo. Ugh. Wait, what am I doing? How do I get in there? Oh, right. Down here. Obviously, monkeys are immune to spikes. Oh! Give me that. That's what you're supposed to do. Not sure how you collect things with watermelon seeds, but I'm also not sure how you collect things with eggs, so best not to worry about it. stick the DeviantArt fetish Pokemon in their own box. Yeah, I know, I was just insulting the stupid leg Pokemon. I'll still get them all, but, I'm not particularly happy with this Pokemon, this gen, design-wise, so far. I mean, maybe some of them look better in-game. Maybe once I see the full roster, I'll like it more. But, I don't want to talk too much Pokemon Sun Moon, because, you know, spoilers and stuff. Plus, I haven't really played too much myself, so spoilers are dangerous for me as well as, you know, other people in the chat. Oop. There we go. Yeah, I'll probably just do what I do now. I guess it'd be hard to resume my, Pokédex numbering scheme. Like, on my current... On XY, I have... all my Pokemon in Pokedex number. I have a living Pokedex, so I have boxes by Pokemon number. I probably won't continue that until I get my boxes back. So, yeah. I haven't got it yet, Annie. It'll still be there. It's fun to play at first with, you know, when everybody's playing, but, people still be playing for a while. As long as you can get it before, oh dang. He just swooped right down. Oh, that's bad. Hold on. That was awkward. Let's pretend that didn't count. What was I saying? Oh yeah, as long as you get the game before- aw, dang it! Doesn't respawn. Oh well. Before the Pokemon Bank releases, there'll be a burst of people that come back to it. Has anyone actually played Pepsi Man? I would like to play Pepsi Man. I saw it at AGDQ, like most people probably did. But, get back. Mario! I blame Mario for that one. Frick. Oh, for Pete's sake! Yoshi, get up! I blame Mario for that one, too. We were talking about Pepsi Man? Oh, yeah. Oh, frick. Ugh, I didn't mean to do that. Wait, does this emulator have rewind? I don't know how to use this emulator. Cheat. No, rewind isn't there. How do I rewind? Input, customize hotkeys. Frame advance. I know this thing has rewind, doesn't it? Oh, there's multiple pages? Ugh. R. Oh, I probably should have guessed that. Rewind is disabled! Well, enable that crap. Rewind buffer. What? What did I do? Oh no. Oh. Oh. Huh. So that's how they do that. Anyway, I think everything's back on. Alright. Let's play this level for the first time. I like the little attempt at continuity here. Come here. You're gonna die. Yeah, Pepsi Man is hilarious and ridiculous. I think it's like a rail, like, not shooter, but like runner, I guess. So I'm not sure it's too amazing gameplay-wise. I didn't even intend to do that, that's just how good I am. Test if that's on. What? Oh dang, he goes like frame by frame. That's probably a bit too... Oh, whatever. I don't really plan to use it anyway, but, what? That was weird. I revealed it without actually revealing it. Mm-hmm. Gimme. Oh! Oh! Freaking Gusty! He's coming for you! I think we're dropping less frames, but yeah, I'll definitely be uploading my local copy of this. Speaking of, I messed up when I uploaded the last Slime Rancher. It was missing the audio track, like the in-game music, so I have to re-upload that one. It's rendering right now on my backup PC. Well, it's probably done by now, but it was when I last checked it. Yeah, it sounds pretty ridiculous. It's got a bunch of unfair looking stuff, honestly. It's got kind of a NES design philosophy where it's just like, you know, you make a really short game look a lot longer by making it just ridiculously hard. I don't think you can really make a game like Pepsi Man anymore. Though, well, I guess we did have Sneak King. As long as you did it in a tongue-in-cheek way, which Pepsi Man kind of always was, you can probably get away with that. Yeah, Adver games in general kind of died off pretty hard. Oh, I guess they moved to mobile and, you know, shovelware. But there's still a lot, you know. You're not gonna find, you know, Pepsi Man 4 on PlayStation 4. Sucks, because that's one of fairly few advert games I'd actually want to play. Watermelon was such a good and strange addition to this game. Like, how did that get decided? But it's so good! Oop! Oh yeah, Chex Quest! That was surprisingly good. For April Fools, they made Brutal Chex Quest, or like partial support for Chex Quest in actual Brutal Doom, but I don't think they ever actually finished it. It was just kind of it was like a one-off joke. It didn't really seem very well put together. Huh? Oh, maybe that did respawn, and I just didn't activate it, because I was dumb. We may never know. Even though I set it to hasty, I keep acting like it's the patient controls. They made 3 Chex Quests? Huh. I think I've only ever seen the first. Jerk. I don't know why I'm even getting these coins. Meet your doom! Chex Quest is for communists? Of course. Real Americans eat Reese's Puffs cereal. Reese's for breakfast?! Yeah, it was like a really weird Doom where they had to, like, make it a really bad excuse for there to be not violence. And it makes no sense. Like, you're sending, like, teleport energy at them. Which, like, how do you half teleport somebody? But, whatever. Where's the thingy? No joke, I bought Reese's Puffs. Where is the thingy? It must be down here. Oh, sure enough. Oh! I just bought Reese's Puffs on my way, I got groceries today and, huh? Was there no payoff? Huh, I was expecting that to lead to a thingy. Or maybe it just leads even further. over. Oh, hello. Cheerios. They're not bad. Cheerios are good, but I tend to prefer Reese's Puffs and Kix. Kix are my corn meal. I guess Cheerios aren't corn, they're wheat. But still. Sound effect we've heard far too rarely. Oh, it's Sonic time! As a fellow mascot, I can confirm Chex Man is in fact a communist. Oh my gosh, they are dropping nukes! I always thought it was a little bottle! Hold on, let's freeze frame that. How do I... I never noticed they were dropping bombs. I thought they were dropping Molotov cocktails. Which would also be kind of concerning for a kid's game, but... That's kind of funny how, with pixel art, you never really... Like, you can totally interpret the wrong thing, but it still makes sense in your head, if as long as, like, nobody corrects you. I'll never be able to look at that enemy the same way again. That reminds me of another thing, What's that guy's name in, hold on, this will be worth it, I promise, here we go, wait, that's not quite right, that's not the image I was thinking of, but I guess it'll do. So yeah, this is Aghanim, and I guess a lot of people saw him as, like, being Pokey from... He does look a lot like Pokey. In fact, let me get a sprite of Pokey. Or Porky. Aw, frickin'... Why does it accept background keyboard input? Porky, Earthbound. I wanted a sprite. Come on, Google, work with me here. There we go, there we go. It really does look like Porky's head. Like, it's like exact. But yeah, he's supposed to look like this. So like, this is a crown, not his face. And this is his face, not like... A medallion or something. Anyway, let's get that off screen. Alright, and you need to die now. Sorry. Alright, this is a good level too. I really like in some of these levels in Yoshi's Island, you kind of transition to different areas. It makes it feel a lot more real. So many enemies with so much personality, and I love little secrets like this. How do I get into this one? You just... Ah! I'm so bad at this. Oh wow, I'm pretty surprised that those were persistent. Nah, that's kind of what I expected. Ah, whatever, doesn't matter. Excuse you. Yeah, YouTube has a pretty serious delay next to, Beam. It hasn't really been an issue with chat too much. Now here's Sonic! They're so cute when they don't have the little spikes out. Oh, and I love these mushrooms. These are really good mushroom sprites. They're not sprites, but, you know, graphics. Oh! Here it is! Oh. We got the real firepower now. Oh, look at the little... Look at the stars behind the window. That is so cool. I never noticed that. I never noticed that parallax before. I really love this background. Little jerk stealing their eggs. Oh, get that back! No, burn! There you go. The fire watermelon is pretty good. It's not as good as the ice one. The ice one is fantastic. Yeah, the colors, I wonder what happened with Link's Awakening, because it, I don't think it was a technical limitation. It would have been pretty easy to have Link's hair be, you know, blonde or brown. I guess it was still brown at that point, wasn't it? Would have been easy to have Aghanim be the right color. Yeah, you'll see that a lot with this game. If there isn't a foreground layer, like that popcorn sea sort of area has, there's often two layers of background going on. This game really does fantastic stuff with the layers and all that. Also, note the little leaves push down just a little bit when you land on them. So many great little touches in this. 80s Lynx had pretty brown hair. They actually made a figure of 80s Link. I went and got it just because how often do you see an 80s Link, you know, anything? There you go. Oop. And I think there's some red coins in these. Actually, I think it's the top ones. Don't get that. Yeah, I think it's just these top two. Is this instrument left biased in the original, or is that something that SNES Nix is being weird about? I guess I never would have noticed on the actual SNES, because we just had bad TV speakers where everything sounds the same. Also, I love the little plant thingies. And some of them are super tall and stuff. So... Oh. Oh no, my thing! These bonus games are way more fun than the SMW bonuses. For one thing, they're all like different, like level, like give you item stages. It feels so much better to grab like 5,000 coins than it does to just, you know, get a couple one-ups. Let's see, I forget how we get up there. Oh, I have the key. Ow. That'll do. Yeah, I think that instrumentation's a little bit wrong. What the? Huh? What did that do? Do I have some layer disabled? What did I do? Oh. Isn't... Shouldn't there be eggs? I think I was supposed to have eggs already or something. Alright, I forgot you can do that. Oh! I guess they don't spawn, but it makes the sound. Well, that was embarrassing. Oh, so that's what that was for. Oh well, just coins. Oh, look how good that tree looks. That is a good tree. Very good tree. Wood pet. Hashtag rake friendly is the thing some people do on Beam to let people know that it's okay to, you know, send your chat over. I've never actually been the recipient of a raid on Twitch or anything, but I think it's usually a speedrunner thing, but I just noticed some people doing it on Beam, and I thought, why not? It could be fun, and if it's not fun, I can just stop, you know, putting it in the thing. Flip cards over in pairs. Oh, this is the good one, I think! Yes! Yes, it is! Alright. Say you were here. Ah, dang it. Okay, but yeah, that is by far the best in terms of getting items. And I think we have to unlock this world's bonus game in order to get instant access to that. Monkey's favorite lake. The shy guy's on stilts. Yeah, I like that one because it's a memory test, and it's entirely possible to get all of it. The luck-based ones are not as fun. Shut up, monkey. Oh, this is fun, using the little thing as a boat. Gonna fall for it, monkeys. Vicious fish. Are these cheap cheeps? I think that's cheap cheap. I'm not sure about the vicious ones that like float around. I guess they look. I guess they're just angry cheap cheeps. Yeah, because those are cheap cheeps. What did that monkey do to get stuck in there? Like, was he born in there? I love how you can see Yoshi sticking his dumb head under the water. Like, what is he doing there? It looks ridiculous. He's a pacifist monkey. I don't know if anyone watching was in here when I shut off the filters, but well, I guess I shouldn't pause while I do this. SNES 9X has some neat filters for stuff. It's like, you know, standard scan lines. Isn't that a little heavy-handed, by the way? But it's also TV mode, which I think is reasonably accurate for CRT stuff. And there's these other ones. That's not what I meant to select. Okay, here we go. There's this one. I think this one looks the most accurate. This is like crappy CRT filter. You know, this is composite, which is a bit noisy. S-video and RGB, which I think this is about the best you can get from a CRT TV. I don't tend to play with CRT filters on, but as far as CRT filters go, this seems to be pretty good. Probably won't play with this for long. Yeah, I'll probably just turn this off. But SNES 9X seemed to have pretty decent tilt things. It also has the stupid garbage like this crap, which I do not like. It looks kind of eh. That's the sort of thing where it kind of like it looks okay on that tree in the background there, but a lot of stuff looks weird. Like Yoshi looks weird. I'm just gonna play it normal. I was never a big fan of scan lines. I tend to prefer. I don't mind them. I don't mind scan lines. Like Axiom Verge uses them. Like it uses them rarely to drive home a point, but it doesn't really. Yeah, it doesn't really do much for me. I can see the appeal of the cartoony filters, but there's just always something that it gets wrong. It usually the background looks a lot better than the characters, and the characters just look dumb. Yeah, NES and SNES emulators pretty much always have those weird little filters. The absolute worst is bilinear filter. I think that was on by default. Bilinear filtering is awful. Look at this. Yeah, it's this little option in here. Look at this garbage! It looks like I took off my glasses. That's what this looks like. I hate it. Give me the crisp pixels. If you're not gonna do, like, go whole hog if you're gonna do something like that. Make a CRT filter, which they do have. Don't just blur it. It's nearest neighbor and nothing for me. Oh, wait, is there something up there? No! There you go. Hold up. I like that they have little shorter spears just to fit in here. Oh, these dudes! These dudes are great. No, 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 don't hit me! Come over here. Come over here! You almost never see these things in the game. Come here! There you go! I loved how we squish it. So fun. And yeah, the bubbles do nothing. I think they just bump enemies back a bit. I'm not sure we ever see those things again. But yeah, that's just one of those fun little enemies that are so rare. It's Q-Bert's cousin. I love the water effect on the background there. Or I guess it's fog. There's the little waterfalls and stuff. Oh, this freak! Oh man, this guy. Look at him. Ugh. Shh, this guy freaked me out. The freaking sound he makes? I love the slow sinking when certain sprites and stuff go into the water. Wait a minute. Oh, no, 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 no. Frick. Uh-oh. That was kind of close. Why even bother locking the door? Whatever. I think these just always have a locked door. Popping balloons! Yeah, I don't like this one. It's pure luck. If it's on his side, he pretty much just wins. No! Yes! Clutch! Aw, it's only a plus 10. But I earned it. Woo! Uh-oh. Oh, no, no, no! That was a close one. Aw, I thought that was for sure there would be something over there for my trouble, but no. Also, note the, like, creepy- oh, frick! The Kirby, like, vacuum thing he does. Ah, frick. There we go. Oh, that was not a smart move. That was a dumb move. Oh my gosh. Nope! Get out of the water, Yoshi! Get out of the water! Ah, frick! Ugh. 40 lives. Oh, dang. Oh, wait, no, this is just immediately before this area. Oh. It's a pretty late mid-ring. Though some levels have two. I didn't notice that this had two. Can you hit this guy? Uh-oh. Okay. I wonder, did I get to keep that? I think you do. Yep. Round two. Alright, you can beat him up. I guess that's how you're supposed to... Oh, dang! That was lucky. Yeah, I usually like to get that first one from him, just in case it's that. The one on his side, if it happens to be that one, like the one immediately closest to him, you just basically lose. I think that's just a one-up in there, isn't it? Yeah, because we already got the flower. Risking your lives for one up is such a video game thing. Oh right, you can skip eggs on water, by the way. I haven't really done it yet. Oop. That wasn't really the angle I meant to skip it at, but... There we go. Uh-oh. Come out of the water, you jerk. I need that precious coin. There you go! Ah, whatever. It can't be anything valuable. Aw, oh, please be matching game. That should be 100, yep. Heck yes! It's more of an Indigo Yoshi, really, but... Oh crap, I immediately forget everything. I'm really bad at my trick. I have... Ah! I had ways to do this. Aw, oh, frick. That was horrible! I just immediately forget. Oh well. That'll be the first one we get. This'll be the first world that we 100%, because then we'll get immediate access, or permanent access to that. Also one of my favorite bosses in this game. I'll try to do the trick, but I want to fight him legit because he's an awesome boss. But there's a funny little Easter egg in here. The contrast of those happy little hills with the spooky music. Also, technically speaking, these things are pretty cool for SNES. The little expandy dudes. Uh-oh. No, spit out a thing. Spit out a thing! Aw, oh, don't make me watch all of this. There you go. One more. There you go. He looks like Strong Mad! Alright, these things. I don't think you can kill those. What is this beating heart sound? Like, what is going on? Oh, it's little ravens! I could have done the save state, but I don't really want to cheat just for that. Also, I swear two of those coins had the red coin sprite, but they weren't red coins. I guess in this level, it could be a pump that is making that sound, but... In other areas, it's not as clear. Is there something spooky in that water? Oh, right! This is a fun trick, so... Water, but if you ground pound... Oh, hold on. If you ground pound from the top, you can ground pound down and you walk on the water, underwater. I'm not sure if that's intended or not, but... interesting little side effect. Gotta go fast. I love the piranha being pushed around by the water. I guess they don't have roots. What's this? Try to throw an egg at the arrow end. Hello! You can get the coins placed underneath. Yep. Or I can just fall into the water like an idiot. That's supposed to teach you to skip eggs on water, which I just explained a couple levels ago. What's this? Oops. Oh. Ah! Ah, whatever. Oops. That's not what I meant to do. Violets are red. Roses are red, violets are blue. Never forget what I say to you. Timing is all, and aim true. Measure the angle and wind do. I completely forgot about that one. One of the localizers was having fun there. Oops. Let me get some eggs first. Hey, Dennis. Back to the horrible pumping sound. Oh dang, you can't climb the... Uh-oh. Oop! Ah, frick! Slow down there. Oops. Right, those just kinda spin if you hit them. Hold up. Gotta be sneaky! You gotta be sneaky, Charlie! Sneaky! Sneaky! Also, I never noticed as a kid, the little buds, the reason they have the weird colors is because it's the colors of a piranha plant. It sort of ties their life cycle together, I guess. A lot of people consider Luigi's Mansion to be one of the last games in the Mario timeline. I don't really think, like, I think it's reasonable-ish, like, there's hints of a timeline in Zelda, though I don't really think all of it was deliberate. Like, I can't really buy the whole three timelines thing. That seems like they tried to tape things together. But Mario is pretty clearly, they never tried for that. I never would have thought Kirby would do it either, though, but recently, as of... Well, they got sort of hints through several games, but definitely as of Robobot, it really does seem like the intent is to have a can. Also, his face just disappears. Poor guy. Boop. Oh! Frick. Hold on. You gotta be sneaky, Charlie. Hit him on the rebound. We'll take that. Oop! Hello! Why is he full of shy guys? Is that his fetish, or...? Uh-oh. And Indigo Yoshi is such a friggin' boss, just going through all the forts. Or castles, rather. No biggie, let me handle that. Uh-oh. Uh-oh! Ooh! That was clutch. Also, there's one frame. How do I... Is there a... Nah. There's, like, one frame where you can really tell, like, that the egg is crowning in Yoshi's swallow sprite, or animation. His eyes do this little thing where you can tell there's some discomfort going on. Alright, give me the... Give me the things. No, I mean like a pause the emulator button so that I... Oh. Hold on. There you go. There you go. You can tell that the egg is it's coming out of there. Look at it. Look at it, look at the poor guy's face. That is not a pleased expression. Poor Yoshi. All right. Boop. Aw, oh, come on, man! Zelda timeline just to shut people up? Probably, yeah, that does make sense, but... Like, Twilight Princess is clearly an Ocarina of Time, you know, sequel, but I don't really think... I don't think OOT and... Like, the links back to Zelda 2 and crap. Like, nah. Nah. Aw, oh, come on. I keep forgetting you can lock the frickin' angle. There we go. Oh dang, no mid goal? Or no midpoint? Wait, I need eggs, hold on, I need eggs for something. I guess one egg is gonna have to do. I'm gonna save just for this one trick. I wouldn't normally, but there's a little trick here, and I need to save state because I don't want to actually win this way anyway. I've never actually done this before though. That wasn't it. What does the reload save button? Load. Oh, okay. That wasn't it. Ah, frick. Okay, let me save a little bit closer. Like I said, I've never actually done this before, I've just seen it done. Wait, do you have to... Aw, oh, come on. Do you have to... There we go! Oh my! Yeah, we're gonna fight him for real, but that's a really funny Easter egg. Another reason Indigo Yoshi's a badass. Give it up, you... Yoshi, you cutie without a navel? Oop, forget it. Did he just hit on me? K-Mac, I do not want your old crusty wizard ass. I'm sorry. Hey, Capitalist. I love this freaking boss. Some people have said it's, you know, it's not a hard boss, but it's so cool. And he's a really complicated boss, too. His little independent vines and stuff. His independent vines don't need no man. You hate his descendant? Would that be the lava piranha? Lava Piranha was a fun fight, I thought. He is kind of slow. Do the Yoshi. Give them sweet, sweet eggs. Yeah, I know what you're trying to pull, son. Aw, too slow. There you go. Alright, give me some things. I'm looking for a game which you can spend a lot of time on 3DS. I mean, Pokemon and, Monster Hunter will definitely give you a lot of hours. For a more offbeat one, I really liked Etrian Mystery Dungeon. And the normal Etrian Odyssey games will last you a long time, too. I don't tend to play, you know, because of long playtime. I tend to, if anything, I tend to avoid long games. But those are all pretty solid. Oh, come here. Ooh! There we go. Oh, no! Oh yeah, Animal Crossing is another one, but, no! Why am I so bad with that? I'm not sure how many people the new Animal Crossing update managed to snare, like, to play continuously, because I played it briefly, and I set up my new storeroom and stuff, but I wasn't really ready to commit all that time, because it's a very time-consuming game. And, like I said, I really just have tons of stuff to play. Oh, of course he was one hit away. Oh, and he has the coolest frickin' death animation. I like how you just get a key to, like, an alternate dimension in the castle. Oh yeah, Dragon Quest VII is out. There's a lot of RPGs on 3DS. There's a lot of games that'll give you a lot of time. $2.99s. This map is still amazing. World 4. Go! Go, Mario! Oh, now we finally see the highly animated Goombas. You can smush them. I'm not sure why you can smush them. But it's pretty great. They don't seem to mind very much either. They're just like, yeah, this is my life now. Oh, you're talking between ACNL and Dark Moon? Dark Moon was good, but not as good as the original, Luigi's Mansion, and, I wouldn't really say, unless you really want to get 100%, I don't think it's really gonna give you an amazing amount of time. I mean, it'll give you your, you know, what is it these days, 30 bucks, 20 bucks? Well, I guess it's a Nintendo release game, so probably 30 to 40, but, it's not bad, but it's not gonna last you forever like Animal Crossing will. Though it depends highly on how, you know, engaged you stay with Animal Crossing. Oops. Almost oops anyway. Yep, actual oops now. Excuse you. Jerk. Pretty crystal background time. Aw, you jerk! I saw you! They make really good use of— oh! He respawned while he was still on screen! That's hacks. Wait, he's just a normal Shy Guy though. Until he pops back around. What a jackbutt. I see you. Oh, he was hiding behind a normal Shy Guy. What? Huh. How have the bandits not made a return either? The bandits are so cool. Jerks, but, wait, were the bandits in Paper Mario? I forget. US commercial for Yoshi's Island? I'm not sure I ever saw that as a kid. I didn't see many commercials really for games. Bandits are in Paper Mario. That's what I thought. Excuse you. Boop. Is it full of 90s edge, the commercial? Up. Oh! Yeah, what was the deal with these guys? Are they just invincible? It's just like Kirby's Dream Land 2, seriously? I have to see it then. Hold on. Hold on, how do we do this? Monitor capture, I guess. No, that's not. No. Yes.
Wins too much, too much? To find out, we crammed everything into Super Mario World 2 Yoshi's Island.
Oh my god.
Massive enemies, huge Yoshi tricks, all served up with the latest graphic technology, Morph Nation.
No more.
Sure you don't have room for another little bonus level?
Uh oh.
Oh my god.
Super Mario World 2.
What is wrong with you, the 90s? I actually do remember that commercial. I probably just, you know, didn't want to remember. But, wow. What is wrong with you, 90s? Like, holy crap. The stream is now rated NC-17 for exploding... Fat man. That's a reference to that. What movie is that? The wafer thin guy? That must be a reference to that, isn't it? But yeah, wow. Are you even allowed to show that on a frickin' commercial? Like, cause commercials have to be like rated E for everyone or whatever, right? Whatever the TV equivalent is. I don't think that ad would fly these days. That's like, wow. It also killed the chat. I'm not sure it's hit YouTube yet by the time I'm saying this. Wait, hold on. Levels are a bit too open sometimes. I'm not sure if I'm going the right way, which is obviously the wrong way to go. Or the wrong way, which is, you know, has all the secrets. Oh, frick! Also, fun thing about the ice. It freezes enemies in their exact location. Hey, Carnimoldia? PG? Nah, PG isn't really E for everyone. That's like T. Because you can swear a cuss on PG. On PG-13. Or I guess there's PG and PG-13, but... I don't know. I don't think that would even be PG. Like, frickin' dude exploded. That was... Wow. The 90s had problems, honestly. Luigi's Mansion is rated E and it has dead babies. I guess that's a way to put it. Aw, yes! Hold on. Aw, yes. I had forgotten these guys pop up again. Love how it affects the music, too. Look at his eyes! He's freaking blazed. I never noticed the eyes go red before. I need another hitman. The music is so good. Oh no! Also a naughty naughty. What does this remind you of? This would get somebody fired at Nintendo these days. Might have gotten somebody fired in those days. Chauncey's bio says he was born a ghost. Oh. That's such a Nintendo thing that they would do. You can't have babies can't die, so he was just born. He was always a ghost, you know. Oh, it's Wigglers! It's Wiggler Wednesday, everybody. Wait, are they still Wigglers when they're the butterflies? I don't know my deepest lore here. Oh. That's on the way back. Also, do we even see Wigglers again in this game? They're one of those enemies that are like really rare. Oh, did the frickin' dining room ghost eat himself to death? I forgot. It's been a while since I played Luigi's Mansion. That's a really great game. I love that the GameCube's design philosophy was just fantastic. There were so many weird, out there games. It was not like a safe, like the Wii, a lot of the Wii sequels, they were great, but they were very safe. Like DKC Returns, Galaxy kind of builds off the 64 formula, but a lot of the GameCube stuff was really gutsy. Like, we had Pikmin, we had Luigi's Mansion, Mario Sunshine. There's just a lot of stuff that was like Metroid Prime. You know, a lot of really risky stuff. Anyway, a chance to gain an item, flip only one card. Oh, yeah, this one isn't. We got this one before. Oh, is this the really long cave? Or no, is that one later? Oh yeah, the Cave of the Lakitus. Also, another really good use of palette swapping with the background here. I forget which pipe it is. There we go. Oh wait, hold on. Wait, how do I exit? Oh man, this rewind is really bad. Why is it frame by frame? Yeah, you can go into the left. I should remember that. Alright, a good little one-up chance here. Classic Mario move there. What is that sound supposed to represent when the shell is getting wet? I can't hurt the little friend. We're just gonna leave that. Alright, you can knock him into the little thing. We have to be nice to the tap-taps. Oops. Oh, I thought there was gonna be a warp thingy, but I guess it's just a pow block up there. I forgot all the ghosts had like excuses for their doom in Luigi's Mansion. That is pretty grim. Oh, ow! Hey, whoa! I didn't think those could go through there. Oop. Oh frick! I thought I could go over one, but not two. Huh? There you go. Love the little sparkles on the stalactites and stuff in the background. Yoshi begins to fall after hovering. There you go. Oh, and it suggests using the magnifying glass, which I don't believe is necessary if you... Yeah. You can just spot which ones are red. No, 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 no! Okay, whoa. It's okay, I think we got all of them so far. Was that four or five? I think that was five. What? That is not the direction I wanted you to go in, my friend. Frick. That's just rude. I wonder if I can find another shell. Nope. I don't suppose I can take you back. Ooh. Can I? No. Wait, maybe it'll respawn. He did respawn! Okay. There we go. Okay. That's very nice of them. You can jump over those, as you just saw, but it's a fairly close shave. I was never super great at it. Fun little physics or whatever demonstration there. What's the minigame today? Aw, oh, not this again. Alright. Wait. Alright. Nope! There we go. Okay. Yes! Aw, we only get a 2-up? At least we did a cool back flip, or front flip. Whatever kind of flip. Secrets. Boink. What are those arrows pointing towards? It's never a bad time to replay Yoshi's Island, in my opinion. Yeah, my backlog is pretty much infinite at this point, too. Oof. Closer than I was intending to make that. I'll save that one. Uh-oh. I didn't realize that thing was spinning. Shut up, phone. Yeah, one definite improvement that Yoshi's New Island has is that it will, in fact, if you get all of the... I'm not sure you can get through that. Shut up! What app is frickin'... You... Ugh. I installed Tap My Katamar and played it once, and it's sending me notifications. Ugh. If you want me to not play your game anymore, just make it give me notifications without my permission. You can disable that in Google Play games, though. Ugh, stupid things. I shouldn't have to. Notifications. Whatever. I'll just turn my phone on mute. Alright, this level. Is this the one? Nice pink sky in this level, too. When you jump off one of these platforms, the number is reduced by one. Oh, yeah. I love the little patchy aesthetic it has going on for it. Oh yeah, it's the level with the balloons and these things. Yeah, this is a really fun level. Wait, is there anything fun over here? Yes, there is. Wait, what was that? Was that... I think a thing just disappeared somewhere. That's a twofer. Oh. Boop. Excuse me. There we go. I like this little bit of continuity here. Is it even higher up? Oh, yep, here it is. Oop! I'm not missing another one of you. Do I? I think I must have missed one of those jerks. Because I heard that laughing sound they make. Oh yeah, too many of these guys make some slowdown. Oh no! No! Ah! Whatever. We're not playing for 100% yet. Excuse you! I am the one kidnapping this baby. I mean rescuing. Kid rescuing this baby. Oh, hello. Not that it matters. Yeah, missing just one thing in this method of 100%ing does, you know, make you, you know, just feel like there's no point in finishing the level even. But, I would love a ROM hack that just adds only that feature. It's really all the game needs. Alright, this thing. Another little fun thing that's like only in one freaking level. You're watching 90s game commercials? I wouldn't recommend it. '90s commercials are kind of the worst. Look at this crap. And that's how you make somebody feel accomplished. Why were all the Kirby ads so bad? Ah, yeah, it was those two laughing jerks. Please be match two. Ah, it's this crap. Look how freaking meticulous it is. I do like that it has multiple different ways of scratching it off. It does add a little bit of flavor to this. Ah. Close. 62 lives. I don't know if we'll be okay, you know. We might want to play a little careful here. Oh, yes, it's March and Milda's fort. This is a really well-designed level. I really liked it. I also love the little background stuff going on. It's like another, like... It kind of shows that the whole world, like, really is, like... It just gives this sort of consistency instead of just, like, you know... The world is only like this because we're on a level, but no, like... The background areas are, you know, designed like this too. Uh-oh. You know what? I'm not gonna miss a coin that early. Also, the chomp is pretty cool here. Oh, you can skip that? I didn't know that. I love when games just have that sort of internal consistency. I didn't explain that very well, but you hopefully know what I mean. Uh-oh. I love this part. Ouch! Aww. Poor guy. Rip. But yeah, so the way this thing is set up, I think you can take that goal ring at any time, but there's four different areas you can go to, and you need four keys to progress. And there's a little preview of what awaits you. And look at that heat distortion! How many freaking SNES games would do that? Please do not swim in a bucket in lava. It will not protect you as well as video games have told you. In fact, just being in the same room as lava is, like, only slightly less dangerous than just actually just jumping right on in. Frick. Oh no, we're down. We only got 60 lives left. Gotta be real careful. The secret here is to just not do flutter jumps. Because flutter jumps will slow you down a lot. Oh, and don't do that! Frick! Don't try this at home, kids, but if your home is a lava castle, you have bigger problems. I kind of wish my home was a lava castle. I would just make sure to have the proper, you know, lava-safe equipment. But, that would be pretty cool. Keeps the neighborhood hooligans out. Let's try the spikies first. I'm at home among the spikes. This is the one of these things that eventually disappears. Excuse me. No. Ah. And this is the one that doesn't. This is a fun little, not puzzle, but they sort of eat away at the walls of that if you're too slow. I want to say there's something hidden up in there. Ah, frick. That looks suspicious. Never mind.
Ow.
How dare you heal? Oh right, the sulfur too. I think just the ambient temperature is enough to kill you too. Yeah, lava isn't particularly safe to be around, even if you just avoid, you know, touching it. Like video games. The phobia of volcanoes as a kid. That's one of those things where fortunately it's pretty easy to avoid volcanoes. Unless you're, you know, a video game protagonist. Leave that rock in the lava. Also, these jerks. Yeah, that lava will defeat you instantly. Uh-oh. Oop. I'm not sure if that spray will, like, the edges of that, but I didn't want to find out. Sure, let's do midpoint. Also, you might just want to open the freaking doors, because that gets the keys out of your inventory. Otherwise, you end up with four, and then you have two less eggs that you can get. Oh! There's even more midpoint goals. I forgot about that. Oh, come on. Hashtag midpoint goals. When you think you're growing up, you always thought quicksand would be a prominent danger. Where does quicksand even is that, where is quicksand even a thing? Oh, these spiky hat dudes, these are fun. Another fairly rare enemy. I think they show up more later. All right. Another one of the cool enemies that skews and squishes. Also these super realistic 3D platforms. You probably fake that doing a sprite pretty easily, but still a neat effect. In fact, that may be a faked sprite, but I do think they could do that with Super Effects Chip. Oh, right. Yeah, that's fine too. Don't need anything down there. Quicksand may be found in riverbanks near lakes, marshes, and near the coast. Huh. I would have thought it would, like, require some very specific circumstances. Oh yeah, when they land, they speed up. I forgot about that. They also can be knocked into each other, oddly enough. What the? Hmm. Now this thing, I don't think you could fake with a sprite, or it'd be a lot harder. Be a very big sprite. And this one's just Spikeball Land. Nothing to fear here. Just a friendly neighborhood Spikeballs. Breakout time. Wait, how did they not defeat you? Come here. Oh, you jerk! You have to hit those three times. Oh, hey. Aw, no. Oh, wait, I still have one left. Aw, it wasn't anything important anyway. Also, the Sniffits should not make that loud of a boom. Like, that is exaggerated. It's the same noise that Bullet Bills make. Oop. Oh wait, maybe it is the Bullet Bills making that sound. I think it's both. Alright, now it's spikes. She's not actually a very prominent danger so far in the quote-unquote spike room. If it so can be called. Alright, they take 3 eggs too, I think. Uh-oh. Alright, there we go. Uh-oh. Oh, Bullet Bill. No. Very satisfying to stomp on those. Alright. Survival lessons with Sir Tap Tap and Co. We're gonna teach you how to survive in real video game situations. Such as shoving your tongue directly down a cannon. There were very few spikes in that spike room. I object. As a connoisseur of spikes, I am disappointed. There were 2 areas full of spikes, and one was of basically no risk. Survival tip, make sure your bathroom floor is dry. Is that an actual thing that people slip and die in their showers? Like, I've never, like, slipped in the shower to that sort of extent. And I really doubt. Oh, you gotta make the drama for the movies, though. The cheats physiology just plain baffles me. This is a really cool boss fight. Look at his face! He's just having a good time. Yoshi! Oh dear! Well, Marching Milda will pound you to bits. And by pound, he means just gently walk about the stage. The fort bosses are like... Aside from the froggy, the fort bosses are fairly benign. Wait, is this the castle? Or no, this is the fort. So the speedrun does really cool routing to minimize the amount of these dudes that you smash. But this is a really cool fight. It's over very fast and not very hard, but still pretty cool. It's also a good show of how many freaking sprites the SNES can really handle. Mario World would be stressing out after like 4, I think? Of course I got the Homestar Runner reference. I slip those in once in a while. I'm surprised they never really referenced this game that I'm aware of. By that I'm aware of, I mean that I remember, because I've watched, like, everything they've made, like, 5 times at this point. Alright, it's another Chomp Rock time. I've heard complaints that Chomp Rocks slow down the game, but there's really fairly few times you ever need to push one around. There's this level, obviously. It's the Chomp Rock, roll it as far as you can and see what happens. Oh no. Friends, no! Okay, we're going by Fallout pacifist rules, and we're gonna say that that was, you know, that was self-inflicted, so it doesn't count. You know, I did nothing to push it into them. I mean, it just happened. Oh no. Can I save him? Get out of the way! Sorry, I have to herd you to safety. Oh yeah, I read the wiki too. This is for your own good. Oops. Sorry about that. Okay, I don't think this is gonna work. Guess we just have to go. Jump! Ah. Oh. Wait. I don't think you're supposed to go down there. I think that's the bad ending route. That's what happens if you don't max out your Lily rank with the Chomp Rock. So I think this seems like a good place to hide something. Nope. Alright. Yeah, with the Chomp Rock in play, it's kind of hard to avoid things. Nothing. Alright. Ugh. Don't get squished. Wait a minute. Is this... Oh! Wait, I think it does I think it has to go down there, actually. Ooh! That was a little dangerous. I'm not sure if they can squish you, but I think... Well, I just don't know, that's all. Oh, the little melon friends were there! Uh-oh, where'd the Chomp Rock go? It better not have despawned. Okay, good. It went so fast that it didn't hurt the tap-tap. Sorry, friend. It's fine. It's just a little shell in the posterior. Us tap-taps are made of tougher stuff. No, get away from that! What are you doing? You know that's not safe. No, I insist that you stop that! I have to move this! You little hooligan. Oop! Oh, right. No, hold up. Hold up, Rock. I don't know why people always say they're unhatched offspring. I mean, you can make an egg that's not fertilized. I mean, most eggs aren't. Well, I don't know about most eggs, but... You know, chickens and stuff lay unfertilized eggs all the time. Oh, right. This part, we have to flatten this out. This is a cute one. You gotta flatten out the bridge a bit. I do think the instrumentation is just a teeny bit off because of SNES 9X, but it's vastly less off than Higgin, ironically enough. There we go. Wait, do I have to break this stuff first? Uh-oh, that was a bad idea. Oh! Do I even need to bring this one with me? That was close. No! Ah! Come on, Tap-Taps. You get out of the way. Hey. Let me eat you. No. No, get out of the way. I think if I go back, he'll spawn. Yep! Okay. There we go. Get out of here, you little rapscallion. sure if we need to go in here. Nope. Why are all these Koopas walking around in their frickin' underwear? It's kinda weird. Just gotta say. Alright, hold on, I think we have to wheel it up here. I don't think it gets stuck if we leave it back there, but I just want to be paranoid. Wait, what? Oh, you're just supposed to... Yeah. Oh, right, this thing! We only see this, like, twice. Alright, and you can push it from the side, too. There we go. Alright, just two more coins. I'm not sure if we missed something or not. I guess we did. Frick. Yeah, there's a lot of really smart reuse in this game that I never really noticed before. Those trees we'll see later in an ice level. Which one is it drawing? Ah. It's quite possibly the most boring one. And it has the highest chance of screwing you over, too. There's three freaking Kamek squares. Also, I like the theming of the worlds. It's not super strict theming, but it's just enough to be noticeable. Like, this is kind of autumn world. Last one was water. The next one's gonna be snow. The last theme is pretty obvious. What the? Kind of a pointless room. Parker. Mew! Come here. Ah, don't put your claws in me. Oh! Give me that. Not really much point to that, is there? In fact, I think this one blocks stuff off from you. Ah! No, Mario! Mario! Aw, oh, you little butt! I think that's the first time we've got a game over from losing freaking Mario. Nope! Get wrecked! I do really like that. Even if they grab him, as long as you grab them from him, you still have a little bit of time after it goes to zero. Not this time, sucker. I cannot ever call those red flowers to give you stars anything but the flesh god. Yeah, they are kind of creepy. I never really thought about it before, but they're kind of like carnivorous flowers, aren't they? I mean, usually I end up putting eggs in them, but yeah, kind of weird. Kind of weird. It's so weird that you grab the shy guy first instead of the... Uh-oh. Coin. It's some good old-fashioned Koopa thing. you guile thee and come back. Alright, this is a fun one, because you can't just smush it from here. You gotta... There we go. That was kind of close! No! Oh, hello. Popping balloons. Oh! If you do that, he goes after you. Okay, so I think... Huh? Ah! Oh! That's dumb. This is Kirby commercial with a Rambo knockoff? Ugh, the 90s. Why? I mentioned this in the Earthbound Halloween hack stream, I think, but there's a really good write-up by Frank Gaddafi, I believe it was. He's a big internet archivist for gaming stuff. About how Earthbound was received contemporarily. Which is, spoilers, is not well. Pretty much everyone hated the graphics at the time. Some reviews even didn't like this game for the graphics. Because, you know, it wasn't blood and gore and edge. It wasn't 90s enough. Crawling in my skin. Etc. Oh, wait. Wait. Can I get down there? Oh, wait, no. I think you just come out the other side. I love the cute little transitions like this. Kirby tends to do that, too. You'll find, you know... Well, you know what I mean. Ha! Boop! Ah, frick! Get back here, you little... You little rapscallywag. Even though I was born in 1990, can... That's exactly how I feel. I was also born in 1990, and it's hard to believe the 90s were in fact a thing. Oh, whoa. I forgot about these things. There's so many single or low use things in this game. Oh, right. Yeah! Oh, wait. Do you have to keep taking this along? Nah, I don't think they'd make you do that. Would they? Maybe they would. I just need a lot of eggs. Okay, wow. Really? I don't think this is going to go over far enough, is it? Oh, maybe with enough- Ah! Oh. Oh, I'm frickin' stupid! Okay. That makes things a bit easier. The moment after I do that, I see, can you eat it in the chat? I can't believe I didn't think of that. I guess it doesn't look that edible. I mean, it's very large. Oof. Uh-oh. Clutch! Okay, and that's not a red coin. Is there... I'm worried. Is there stuff down here? Oh, okay. I shouldn't be worried, this isn't Donkey Kong Country! Oh, fuck, God. Gave myself a heart attack. yeah, Donkey Kong Country would totally do something like that. But, I was a little doubtful Yoshi's Island would do something like that. Make you jump into a pit wondering if it was a thing or not. But yeah, that wasn't my favorite room in this game. It's pretty tame compared to stuff we'll see in the special levels, but that's still a little hairier than I would like to see. Oh, frick. This level is all about the clutch moments and the almost dying. Like, holy crap. Are you still finding edgy 90s commercials over there, son? Uh-oh. No, baby, not now. You're not allowed to do this while there's a red coin in play. Wait. I think if they don't fly in, I don't think they despawn like the other ones do. Wait, how do I... Alright, but... Where's the bridge? I'm trapped in this cycle. Uh-oh. That makes the tap-taps climb up, doesn't it? Oh wait, not yet. I think you can avoid the tap-taps climbing if you don't activate that one, but too late now. Wait, no, maybe that's good because they climb all the way to the top. I can just slide under them. Note that the closed petals make a sad face when you're distant enough from the flower. So they just climb up harmlessly. Oop! Ah, grief! Get into the water for your crimes. Walk the plank. I love that slow sink effect. Sometimes you gotta be paranoid. Wait. Aw, frick. I guess I gotta waste two of these. Yeah, the items are really useful for getting 100%. Not so much... There's not as much you can do for the flowers, but they can be really helpful for, especially for stars, and somewhat for red coins. You can point out secrets and crap. And I think this will be an important... Wait, is it world 3 or 4 that has the match 2 cards? Because I want to 100% that one first. Sun Gaming, what have you... You've witnessed the Conker's Bad Fur Day commercial. Oh, I don't even... Oh, that one's probably real bad. Oh yeah, the beam comments will be way sooner than anything. Uh-oh. I sacrificed myself to the flower god. I've made a terrible mistake. I've made a huge mistake. Uh-oh. Bus driver takes a bus to one of those press machines. What? I was reading Sun's comments. And he crushes the bus to catch all the Pokemon. Oh my god, I remember that one! Oh my god, that was screwed up. That was... Like... 90s Nintendo is freaking crazy. I mean... Nintendo's still crazy, but... It was a dangerous kind of crazy. The sun was in your eyes. Banned! Oop. That was not how you're supposed to do that. I did it anyway, though. I guess I just gotta do that again. This is a cute way to get around the level, though. It's up, down, and all around. You can get eaten by that piranha plant, though, which is why I was being a little careful there. Because it has happened to me before. I love these pink hills. If there's any background in this entire game that I haven't said I love this at some point, do feel free to point it out, and I probably love that one too, just didn't mention it. Oh, more Huffin' Puffins! Give me your babies. Oh, they run! It's okay, I'm your mother now. Look at my beautiful children. I must protect them. They even change direction when I do. They're so cute. I'm just their mom now. Oh, frick. Wait, they had a Smash Bros. 1v1 me IRL commercial? I didn't know that. Excuse you. Oh, hello. Yeah, I think we ride a thing. Rest in peace, Huffin' Puffin' the fourth. You were a star shining bright in my life. I just almost fell through that tiny gap. Just find me the tiniest gap, and I will find some way to fall through it and die. Are these red? Whoa. Rude. Rude! My button! My button! It ain't my input! I pressed it when it was transitioning, I guess. Woo! Gotta go fast! Woo! Intense! Whoa. Oh gosh. Oh no! My babies! Wait, no, my babies are fine. Oh my gosh, I thought they fell into the pit, but they just spooped up. Ah, we missed a flower! Where did we miss the flower? Alright. This will be our last level for tonight. I guess the streaming... I'll still upload my local copy instead, but I guess the stream has been kind of okay, but I still need to yell at Medicom. I won't actually yell. But I'm still not pleased. Terms of any Japanese Sega Saturn. Buy a Sega Saturn or Sega Shiro will kill you? I didn't know he was like that hardcore. Hookbill. Yeah, this was a fun boss too. There aren't really any unfun bosses really in this game. Aw, this jerk! This world really likes the Koopa Shell gimmick. Oh, I just realized, of course it loves the Koopa Shell gimmick. There's a Koopa for the final boss. I love they kind of sweat as they do the thing, and then they get all relieved when they can drop the weight. It's so cute. They work so hard. Imagine being a shy guy, and you die, and then they conscript your ghost to carry a ball and chain for all of eternity. Like, dang. The chain hurts! The chain hurts, I forgot about that. Oh, We got double egg action. It's building bridges the level. Oh, and you gotta... Oop! Wait, hang on. Oh, I think I screwed this up! Oh, never mind. I thought that bridge was gonna block the other one. I think there is a level where you can do that. But I guess it's not this one. What's this? Oh. I don't remember most 90s commercials, and it's probably for the best. Ah! Mario! I think I want to go up here first, because there's a thing. There we go. Oh right, there's this! This is fun. They don't really do this anywhere else, but yeah. Little mid-boss! Oh, I guess they do it one more time. They do... Don't they do the slimes? They do the slimes in one of the later levels. In fact, I think they do the slimes a couple times. Uh-oh. There we go. Keys! I think you're supposed to use a shell for that. This is a very non-linear level, which is cool. Wait a minute. Oh, I know. Even that door animation was super amazing for the NES. Like, just not- thought that was gonna hurt me. That was just a one-up. Wait a minute, then... What am I missing here? Barf that out. Ah, there we go. Eggs. They don't even mind being naked. I'm starting to suspect Koopa Troopas are nudists. Wait, I didn't need to come here. Oh, too late now. Oh wait, yes I did! Never mind. My autopilot is functioning as intended. You! I forgot about you. Die! That guy's an absolute jerk. I think he can steal his cloud. I just got those stars! It's fine, there'll be a mid-boss. Or a midpoint ring somewhere. Did we get all the... No. This is a fun little puzzle, because you have to get this within all of the eggs here, or you have to use the door to reset. You can't get stuck, but it does force you to be at least a little okay with playing those things right. It's Arkanoid, yeah. Oh, and the art style for these blocks really stands out for some reason. They look different. Like, not bad, but... It just gives us a really interesting feel to this area. Alright, you can't use the full eggs thing. Alright, the mist! This is a really cool lead-in. Regular old Koopa. Koopa came through for now. Go forth and rock Yoshi's World. Kamek stopped hitting on me. Yeah, this was some really cool use of the FX chip. Yeah, it's a really great transition. Oh yeah, this guy gives, like, eggs for free. Alright, get his head! No! Frick! Oh. I think if I die, I will start with... I just want to get keep my 100%. I think if I die, I can get that. Sorry, Mario. Just crush this guy's face in for a bit. Yeah, take him. I don't want him anymore. We had to see that at least once anyway. 70 lives. Do I still have... Yes, I do! Okay, that's good to know. But yeah, this lead-in is so cool. The mist. And then it fades away. Oops. Apparently you can pause during this. Oh, and I really like that it skips the, a lot of games aren't thoughtful enough to skip dialogue and stuff. I'm actually really impressed that this game did, because that... It's fairly uncommon still to see that, but, for SNES... Oh! You gotta be freaking kidding me. Whatever, Mario. Rewind? Oh, true. Oops, I just saved. I'll rewind for something that's like that for you. I didn't have any arrows. I know I can only mute you. There we go. I gotta not be so risky with the eggs. There's no reason to be that risky with the eggs. Oh. I forgot he took that many. Boop! Like, look how he squishes. It's really cool. It was super loud there for 10 seconds. That's just... He's always... Ah! You know what? I'll just do a save state at the beginning, because that... how do I... Do... Oh! No! Oh. I can't rewind any further. Oh wait, yes I can. Yeah, the rewind sounds really annoying. Alright, I'll save if I mess up again. But I won't. Because I can video games. I can be good at video games. Oops. Alright. Alright, now we're gonna play good and bad things won't happen anymore. Because I remember this boss's pattern now. Which is kind of the issue. Oh, I forgot he speeds up. That's a neat little trick of his. Alright, there we go. That was a little embarrassing, but... He kind of folds in on himself, and then explodes, and shrinks somehow. Rip. Can't see Koopa's father. Too bad for a first run through a world. Some more Yoshi terrorism time. Look at his little feets! Oops. Now we go into the sky! Alright, I think the instruments change slightly in each world, don't they? Oh wait, no they don't. Never mind. Anyway, that is Yoshi's Island for tonight. Next week, we'll beat Worlds 5 and 6. Oh yeah, more instruments are added as you go along. I think that's how it works. Because yeah, I don't think this trumpet was there before. It's now officially Hoenn. Hoenn is confirmed. But yeah, next week, hopefully we won't have streaming issues. I mean, we've been half okay through the later part of the night. But yeah, I'll still upload the local copy. I'll always do that whenever we have any notable issues. Look at how freaking Lakitu looks like he's like some sort of godly figure in this icon. But yeah, thanks for watching, everybody. Have a good night, and tune in next week. They're still experiencing problems? Ugh. They freaking... I swear, they just kind of always have problems. I really hope they roll out fiber here. But yeah, I'm gonna head off. I need to, like... There's a couple more games I wanted to record tonight. If I still feel like recording after this, and I need to actually freaking play Pokemon. I really wish Google Fiber would frickin' come around here, but...